Hello everybody, it's the Poltergust 5000 back with more Pokemon Black 2, take 2 of this episode, because the first time I recorded it, I realized 40 minutes in that the game audio was too loud, and then 2 hours after that, I realized that my microphone was down at 70% because of my failed attempt at recording Chapter 2 of the audiobook. Hooray! I also didn't do any grinding, because I'm just that much of a fuck-up.
So, here we are in this Reversal Mountain with its annoying-ass music. Getting into wild battles, training up Tattle slowly but surely. I switched out Tattle's fucking font. What's that font called? It's called, like, F-O-T Reggae Standard Bold Bold. Standard Bold 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 Boldy Bildu. Anyway. Tattle's putting in work, you know? She's kind of a badass. So, there's a whole lot of stuff I need to talk about in this video, which is kind of why... It's not why, it just kind of worked out decently well this way. That I'm not... That I have kind of a grindy nothing episode to use to talk about all this shit. Okay, so first of all... yesterday was Tim's birthday. And it was good. It was great. Tim liked his birthday present. The fucking animation I made of the water hands dancing. Let me actually put that... Can I put that up here? I think I can put that up here. Is there anything over here? Let me open up the dowsing machine. Oh, it's gonna lag because it's garbage and I hate it! Here it is. Oh my god. That's like so unbelievable. I can't believe I fucking made that. And it only took like a couple hours. Anyway, let's get rid of that. So, yeah. So that was fun. I'm probably not... Okay, so here's... So this... we should just call this episode Can of Worms. This isn't dirty laundry because it's not any beef I have with anybody. It's just called Can of Worms. On Wednesday, my grandma on my dad's side had a stroke, and she went to the hospital and she was like unconscious and like low key in pain, like hooked up to morphine and shit. So we all went in on Wednesday night to like say goodbye because we thought she wasn't gonna wake up. So I made my peace, and it was, I mean, it was sad, but it was good. It was like, it was good closure, and it all, and I think it went pretty well, and I was, but then, yesterday, I got a message from my sibling, showing me text messages from my dad, where he went to visit her in palliative care, at the hospital in her town, like where she lived, and she woke up and was totally lucid and okay, and it was like, oh. So it was a really confusing day emotionally, because it was like I had reached the level of closure that I wanted to reach, and like it was all over and done with, and then all of a sudden, it's like, oh, never mind, okay. And obviously I'm happy, but, obviously I'm happy that she's okay, god damn it. But at the same time, it's like, I don't know, it's gonna be really awkward, because we were gonna go visit her later today. It's gonna be probably gonna be pretty soon. I hope I have the chance to fucking finish this episode before we go do that. Because I'm already gonna miss the Hollow Knight stream tonight. Go away, I'm just trying to fucking explore this fucking floor!
What was I gonna say?
Yeah, like... And that's why I was so freaking frustrated. I got really mad on Twitter, like, just... When I realized that 40 minutes in, I realized the game audio was too loud and the entire recording was completely fucking unusable, it was like, oh my god. If this had to happen today, you know? And also, while I was working on Tim's birthday present, I hurt my throat singing along to music like a fucking idiot while I was working on the animation. And because of that, I haven't been able to record chapter 2 of the audiobook of Hit List. I haven't been able to record chapter 2 of that. I recorded like 98% of it on Wednesday, but oh my god, that recording was so bad. It's gonna sound weird to say. It's gonna sound weird, but man, two Boldors? I don't think we've actually seen that before. Even in that 40-minute recording, I don't think I ever saw this exact permutation of dudes. But anyway. I'm using Shadow Sneak just to break their sturdy, because Musharna can take them out with an energy ball. Why did you attack that one? I mean, it doesn't matter, but like, why? We could have finished off... What? What the fuck? Nintendo Capri Sun just commented. I have no idea what he commented on. Maybe it was a reply to the comment I left on the Smalt Parando today. But the comment is just, "Ooh, but it's why? Woo!" And like, I'm probably reading that wrong, but just like, what? Oh, dang it. I used Shadow Sneak on the wrong guy. Hold on. What is that? Is that a reply to what I post? Oh, no. It's on, he watched my episode of Aria of Sorrow that I put up the other day. Awesome. Okay, what was I saying? But yeah, I did a recording of the fucking thingy. Chapter 2. But I had too much energy, I was stumbling over my words constantly. It was like 3-1 bad takes versus good takes, and I was just, I got so mad at myself. Like, if I go back and edit that, because I still have the recording, it's going to be so unpleasant, because, like, every 5 minutes I get so frustrated at myself for constantly fucking up my speech that I just, like, let out some animal sound of anger, and it's like, dude, I don't want to listen to that shit. So I was thinking of, so what I'm probably going to do, what I'm almost certainly going to have to do, is miss the very fucking first deadline for uploading another chapter of the audiobook. Like, hey, this is gonna be a weekly thing. Oh shit, I missed the very first weekly upload after it started. Wow, that's really, really stupid. But that's just the way the toast sometimes, you know? So, instead, I have a video that's gonna go up tomorrow at noon, and at the first opportunity I get, I'll be setting that to my front page, to the video on the front page of my channel, like what Nintendo Capri Sun had with that video called "These 16 LPs Can Be Yours, No Purchase Necessary," or whatever it was called. Something like that, where he had a Bella's Tolling playing from Secret of Mans. Oh, man. Oh, fuck. I was gonna plug in my 3DS, because it's like, okay, it's like 11... It's like 1:22 p.m. in the afternoon, as opposed to 1:22 p.m. in the morning. And I remember at some point either mom or my sibling, excuse me, mentioned that it was that if we were gonna go, it was probably gonna be around 2:30. So I'm like, oh shit. Okay. Am I gonna have time to do whatever I need to do before then? You know, because, and that was before I had the failed recording of Pokemon. It's like, jeez, man. It's ridiculous. I can't believe it, man. But hopefully this one's turning out well, because I turned the game audio down to 23. Okay, here's the really annoying thing about it. So, when I record the audiobook, I turn my microphone down to like 70%. I turn the input volume to like 70% so that when I read emotional, emphatic dialogue, I don't clip the audio. But at the same time, when I adjust the microphone audio in Audacity, it affects the microphone input volume globally across the entire computer. So if I don't remember to set it back to 100%, then it screws it up next time I record, because it sets my microphone input volume low across the whole board. which I just can't. I can't even under. I can't even fathom why that would be the case. But anyway. This week has just been a really shitty week for shit what I be doing. Other than, like, Aria of Sorrow, which is going great, and the birthday gift for Tim, which also went great. I was quite happy with how that turned out. Failed Pokemon recording, missing both streams this week, and a failed recording of the audiobook. It's just like, oh my god. Hopefully next week will be better. It seems like this always happens. I don't know what it is, but every year around my birthday, something goes wrong. The last two years, my birthday, I've had a really bad day on both of my birthdays. I don't know what the hell. I don't know. Like, last year, I was all bummed because I was, like, you know, I was just constantly bothered about the, you know, like, futility of existence and all that shit, and on no day does that feeling become more concentrated on the day, literally, the celebration of me growing older, you know? Unavoidably, inextricably, and, you know, constantly. The constant flow of repeating and repeating, death, repeating. Is there anything to gain from this? No. The way he says, no. And then John laughs because it was so blunt. If you're wondering why I'm only using Tattle here, it's because Tattle is the only member of my party right now who cannot effectively battle Audino. Or Audino? Audino? I don't fucking know. You can pronounce it however you want it, I'd have to believe you. The music in here almost feels like it's some soft, almost feels like it's reversed. Like the main, like, it's like, what the hell is that? It sounds like you took the Twist Mountain music and played it in reverse and, like, slowed it down. But at the same time, it's, like, too... It's too even to be Twist Mountain, because Twist Mountain isn't like... Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. It's like... And I'm so off-key. Well, I missed at least one note in there by, like, a couple half-steps. Oh, man. The half step, like in Zelda 1. What are those called? Is that what it's called? When you, like, hang on. Does anybody else hate how in the new version of Audacity, I don't know if maybe I got the wrong version of Audacity. Yeah, they're called half steps, semitones, half steps. In the new version of Audacity, it doesn't automatically apply an effect to the entire recording if you haven't selected anything. Like, in older versions of Audacity, or maybe I got an older version and somehow I managed to fuck that up when I downloaded Audacity on the new computer, blah, 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 blah. The point is, like, on this version of Audacity I have on my PC, on my new PC, I have to manually hit Control A or whatever before I can use an effect, when before, if you didn't have anything selected and you chose an effect, it would automatically, you know... Actually, like, Audacity would actually fucking use its brain and think, maybe that means he wants to do it to the entire project, instead of being like, duh, what? What do you want me to do? I don't know what you want me to do. I need a selection before I can put an effect on it. Break is sturdy. And then you use acrobatics, and you're fast, and you're fast, and you're fast. Please one-shot him. You're not going to, but... Oh, you did! What do you know? Consider me surprised. Remind me to check. Oh, God. Here's the Darmanitan. Get some more toilet paper. On the first recording of this, this Darmanitan just fucking annihilated Tattle with a flare blitz. And that's probably what's gonna happen here, too. Oh, no, it attacked her. Man, that animation is spectacular. Oh, my God. Wow. Musharna could. I hate that I always sing along to this song when it comes on, because I think the song is, like, really desperate, you know? It's just, like, so desperately trying to make the low health beeps into something interesting, but it totally misses the point of why the beeping was annoying in the first place. It wasn't, I mean, like, the fact that the beeping... The fact that the low health beeping was constantly repeating as long as you had low health was only half the problem. The other half of the problem was that it interrupted the music and you couldn't hear the music as well. Like, you know, the low health theme in these games, in these Generation 5 games, is like... It works in that, like, it's less annoying, for sure. It's less grating on the ears. But it's a lot more annoying in terms of, I just want to listen to the music, man! You know? Seriously. Excadrill. I almost used one of you guys on this run. I was going to name you Shannon or Raymond, depending on if I got a boy or a girl. Named after the robots from OKKO. Which still doesn't have any new episodes out. I saw that My Little Pony Season 9 was trending on Twitter today. It made me so mad because, like, it was trending on Twitter because it was airing, but it wasn't available online anywhere. It's like, it was like a total tease. It's like, dang it, don't trend that before I can watch it. Jeez. Yeah, I watch My Little Pony. I didn't follow Season 8 super closely because, to be honest, the villain of Season 8 was kind of badly written. I thought, at least. It was the villain of Season 8 was, like, super forced. It made me roll my eyes more than anything else. I'm glad that the show is ending before it, like, totally runs itself way into the ground, because Season 8 was already starting on that with the whole school thing. It's like, is this really what we're gonna spend another 7 seasons on? It's like, I know we're gonna end it in Season 9, and I was like, oh, thank God. Thank God for Bianca keeping me alive. Ooh, Tattle's got 108 HP. That's scary. For those of you who don't know, 108 is the number of temptations there are in Buddhism, I think. I think that's right. It's like the number of temptations you have to overcome to achieve samsara. Because I got the boss cuts, because I'm boss cuts. One time, I made a D&D campaign with a group of monks that were based on Buddhism. It was like a combination of, like, the whole samsara thingy and the 5 stages of grief. In fact, their main city, like, the city that the monks lived in, was called Garif. It was like G-A-R-E-E-F. Oh, what was the neighboring kingdom called? I don't remember. I don't remember! Jeez, have I really forgotten that much about that story? Golly. What do we got? A pee-pee up. A PP up. How many full stops? A PP up. Because you have to come to a full stop between saying PP and up. Because, like, you can't go from... I mean, I guess you could say a PP up. But then it sounds like one word. But it still sounds like two words. Because you have to come to a full stop between P and P. You can't go peep, peep. Like, if you want to make a P sound to start off a syllable, you have to start by you have to start from a full stop. Because if you don't, then you make a B sound. You can't go PB up. That's not a P, that's a P and then a B. Nobody cares! Oh my god, nobody cares. But you know what? This week may have been kind of a fucking clusterfuck for me, but at least I have lozenges. I actually walked to the convenience store on Wednesday to buy throat lozenges, because I've gone over a week without them now. I finally ran out of those three bags I bought, those three little packages, so I got some Fisherman's Friends original extra strong, and man, like, when I opened these things up and pulled a tablet out, it was so weird, because, like, the Fisherman's Friends we usually get, the cherry ones, are like these little white pieces. They just look like mints. They're like little white pieces with like red freckles, little red flecks on them. But the regular flavor of Fisherman's Friends looks like a little piece of floured gingerbread, and it tastes like licorice. It's literally licorice flavor. Like it says it right on the fucking packaging. Non-medicinal ingredients: sugar, licorice powder, dextrin, tragosanth. It's like that Brutal Foods video where he's like, man, you can really taste the, and then he like mouths, like mouth flaps like RoboCop, and like a text-to-speech voice is like, monothodium glutamate. It's like, what? It's just the really obvious mouth flaps are the best part of that. Okay, I'm just gonna keep using, keep going after Driftblim with these Shadow Sneaks. You know what? I'm pretty happy with that. That's gonna kill me. Ah! Hoo, hoo. Oh no! Oh! Aww. Wait, what? 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 Huh? Earth Power is a single target attack? I thought Earth Power was I thought Earth Power affected the entire opponent's side. Because I saw that Tidal wasn't vibrating when that Earth Power animation was happening, but I could have sworn. Because it's definitely multi-targeted in Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. Well, there we go. It's one of the most notoriously pain-in-the-ass things about a certain post-game dungeon in that game. The Concealed Ruins, where you find Nidoqueen that just spam that shit. Dang it! You wasted the experience from the... Durr! Daaaaaah! Hope you're next to my bot! Man, look at Rasputin's wings. It's like the exact same sprite. They just moved it a little bit. It's like those pictures I made when I drew all the characters. I drew like all the new unique characters from Paper Mario and the Temple of the Sun, which is a great fanfic that you should all totally read, but I know none of you will because nobody ever does. But you should definitely go read it. Just Google Paper Mario and the Temple of the Sun. It's like Paper Mario 4, but good. When I did that project, I realized that to make some of the bigger characters believable, I would have to do papercraft designs. Which resulted in me figuring out how to make, like, Paper Mario-style papercraft designs in MS Paint, because I was still using that at that point. I hadn't made the full switch to GIMP yet. Because I was on the old laptop, which is a lot slower than this baby right here. So I couldn't use GIMP unless I, like, didn't have anything else open. So what I would do, if I needed to make, like, two... Like, if I had to make a character who looked like Hooktail, you know, who had, like, a head that was made of two pieces of the face that were, like, identical, but they, like, tented at the nose, then what I would do is I would draw the face from, like, one side, and then I would copy it and paste it, and then I would color that one to be, like, the inside So it wouldn't have any features. It would just be a flat color. And then I would take each one and skew them to like and like resize and skew them to be the right angles and then line them up at the part where they tent. And that was how I made those like papercraft designs. I should put one of them up like, well, actually I could do that. Yeah, let me do that like right fucking now. This is so stupid. I'll get the oh jeez, wait, hang on. Oh, stop complaining, you piece of shit. God, you're horrible. Let me open up GIMP right now. I'm gonna open up, wait, no, I don't want embargo. I'm gonna open up a picture right now. Keep old moves. Give up a learning to move embargo, I do not need it. Pictures. Come on. Crop to selection. Take out all the white. Add an alpha channel, then take out all the white. Because of send me far away in a flat. Oh god, ew. Name that LP. Okay, what's this? This is called the Dynamo Dino. It's a mini boss from chapter 4. I will not tell you the context because spoilers, but I'm going to show you this picture. Where is it? Dynamo. There it is, the Dynamo Dino. So that's kind of like what I did. You can see I got like, you can see like the head is like two pieces that I angled differently. And the body is made up of a whole bunch of different parts that I shaded to look like they were folded in half. Yeah, I'm pretty proud of how that turned out. Alright, let's delete that and get a move on here. Over that way is the way out. We can get something from this guy if we talk to him. He gives you that, yeah, false swipe. Oh, you know what else is cool that happened the other day? I hit 250 subscribers. I'm surprised that, like, because I had, like, a huge spike of subscribers after the Earthbound race went out. That took me from, like, 70-something all the way up to, like, 200, and that's when I did Luigi's Mansion. And it's been on a slower burn since then, but I have been steadily rising. It's, like, 7 a month, basically, has been the rate for the last few months here. And I hit 250 yesterday, and guess who the 250th subscriber was? It was Nintendo Capri Sun, the man himself. He was my 250th sub. How awesome is that? If you're listening, Tim, thank you. Lewis. I didn't notice any of these characters. Well, actually, in the first recording, I did notice the name of the ace trainer girl that we fought earlier. Her name is Cora, with a C and only one R. I guess I'll faint attack the fuck out of you. Because whatever. Oh right, at this point, I'd already switched Rasputin into the front instead of Tattle. But I'm gonna leave Tattle in the front now because I know that it's a good idea to. Because Tattle, like I said before, Audino is the best way to grind experience in Generation 5. Hang on, I need to adjust my microphone. I angled it down at the beginning of the video because I was, like, dead on my desk and I wanted you to be able to hear what I was saying. But now I'm not dead on my desk, now I'm dead in a chair. I'm the dead bad Poltergust 5000 edition. What was I saying? Yeah, so Audino was the best way to grind experience in this game, pretty much. But, Tattle will struggle a little bit with fighting them because, well, I guess she can use Feint Attack, that'll work. Rasputin will probably have more trouble, but he's got the Eviolite. Who will have the most trouble? I don't think anybody will really have trouble with fighting Audinos anymore. The problem is there's like a sweet spot of levels that takes up like the middle 40% of the game, where like every Audino you encounter has fucking nature power that puts you to sleep, and it's like so annoying. It's like the most annoying thing ever. Oh, I just ran away. Oh, I can't remember the last time I haven't done that in like literally 2 weeks. Not in Pokemon, at least. I've been running away like crazy in Earthbound. I've been spying Starman Supers to try and get the Sword of Kings for literally like a week. Oh, it's like every time I go to the bathroom, I sit on there for like half an hour searching for the Sword of Kings, and I've had no luck, man. Just give me the sword so I can get on with my life and see what happens when you do Giant Step last. Because I took advantage of the newly discovered one-hit barrier skip glitch that lets you skip right to Tucson as soon as you gain access to one-hit before you even fight the sharks. Oh, Wandola Town is right through here. I want to keep looking around a bit more. What do you think? Should we say bye for now? Yeah, we're done. And now... Ah, God. Oh, one thing about these cough drops, these extra strong fisherman's friends, these are the strongest hot cough drops I've ever had, because they literally burn my tongue if I leave them in for too long. If I don't move them around, then it's like, ow! It's like when you have too much sour candy and it, like, burns a hole in your tongue. It's like, jeez, man. Holy crap. Shiny stone. We don't have anything that can evolve with that, but Lord knows if I had a Roselia, I'd use the fuck out of that, because Roserade is awesome. We're in awe of nature's power. In the initial recording, I went on this, like, salt-crusted rant about how humanity is never impressed by nature's power. Not enough to stop fucking with it, at least. If only humanity would be impressed by nature's power in real life, maybe we'd actually live through the next 20 years. Anyway, what is this? Marine tube ahead. Walk through aquarium. That sounds pretty nifty. This villa belongs to Caitlin, one of the Pokemon League's Elite Four. Cool store.
Fuck you, throat. Ugh.
Hold on. What the fuck did I do to you? Jesus Christ, man. Hold on, I need water. Ugh. I don't know why my throat does that sometimes. It's just like... It's like it shuts the wrong way or something. Anyway. Obviously, our team is still totally healed. Because, because Bianca would have kept us safe in the cave. And there are no encounters between Undula Town and Reversal Mountain, so... Oh, I gotta put the dowsing machine back on. We got a heart scale! Yay! We needed heart scales, because you don't have any. So me, Brand Loyalty Griffin, says, we don't have any. Right there, we got a pearl. Music in here. I'm glad I got to Undula Town in winter, because the music in summer, well, it's a lot more beachy. It's also, like... really energetic and wacky and whoa wacky, and I don't know, I'm just not in the mood for that. But then again, if I was here in summer, then it would be a different day, and maybe I would be in the mood for it. Dude, I don't care about you, Curtis. I already know that I can't get what I want from you before I've already finished the LP, so what the hell is even the point of this conversation? Goodbye. Wait, is there anything else here? It looks like there's a path back. No, there isn't. Okay. The music on Route 14 is really good. I fucking love it. Da, 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 da. Excuse me. I don't have surf. Excuse me. Good God. What the hell? Oh, what? Oh. What the hell? Aww. I took the... Jeez, I did not... I didn't run into this in the last recording session. I guess I just didn't take that one step north. What's up, Onyx? Let's see what you're... Oh, you got an unpheasant? You ready to spam fucking detect like a asshole? I know you are, because that's what you do. Because that's what Mick Unpheasant Mick do. Okay, so let's send in...
Rasputin.
Because he's got a Rock Slide and Eviolite. That should allow him to... handle things nicely. Air Slash. That hurt. Ow! God, I wish you'd evolve so that you would stop sucking! It's unbelievable, man.
I can't believe it, man.
But how the fuck did that do so little damage? Is this a joke? Is this a ruse? Am I to be made a fool, Onyx? Am I to be made a fool by your unpheasant? This is gonna hurt like hell. Ah! Oh, that was a critical hit? Seriously? Is that a joke? Because that's funny. Why'd the air slash do so much damage if that did, like, fuck all? That didn't do shit. Unless it, no, it doesn't always get a crit, so what the hell is the point? I think Dragon Breath would finish you off. I'm just gonna do that because it's got better accuracy. Oh, stop! Stop! Please! Stop wasting my time! I got shit to do! I gotta end this video before we leave so that I can get it uploaded before we leave! You know what I'm saying? I tell ya. At least your music is awesome. There it is! There it is! Alright, that's enough. The worst move in the world move. Wow. Okay. I feel very fortunate to be present at the moment of this monumentous hunger oh, what the fuck. I don't know what the hell he even says there. Simi Sage. Don't really want to fight that outside out buck, because he can kick some ass, yeah. With his spider web. You can throw spider webs and inflict sticky. That's a Jimmy and the Pulsating Mass reference. Just like Buck. Buck's name is, as it were. Ooh, quick attack! Quick attack! Can you say quick attack? Hyper potion. Okay, good. Baby! That's how it's done! Ooh, Lava Plume! That's probably better than Fire Fang. Lava Plume is 80 power, that's 65. You've got a special attack raising, not all but flinch. Tell you what, I'll get rid of Return because I can teach that to you whenever I fucking want. And I'll just kind of gauge the efficacy of both Lava Plume and Fire Fang. Because Fire Fang is a little bit weaker, but it's probably a little bit stronger with the attack power, with the stats. Wee-wee-wee! Go Bug Love! Kick ass with that ass ears! Man, you're fast! Holy cow! Badass! What is this gonna be, a three-part LP then? Oh, that's not gonna do shit or jack. Ha! What? Are you kidding me? That was pathetic! Is that the best you can do? What was I saying? Yeah, because Fire Fang has two effects that it can have. It can flinch or burn, but it's got 5% less accuracy, so it's like, I don't know. But Lava Plume might have a higher chance to burn. It's got higher base power, and it's got better accuracy. Great, it's fine. Name that LP. Well, that happened. And I think, oh, wait, hang on, we want to go over to Undula Bay. And pick this up, and pick this up. It's art scale, and I'm gonna sneeze. Well, come, I mean, seriously, like, don't just seek up and then, you know, seek up and then back off. If you're gonna seek up, then commit. so stupid. Oh, I'm getting a knock on my door. That probably means we're about to leave, and I need to finish this episode. Hello?
Hi. Are you recording?
Yeah, that's what this episode means.
Okay, when you're done,
uh-huh.
We gotta discuss stuff upstairs.
Okay. Okay, do I have time to upload it?
How long does that take?
Like, I don't know, 5 minutes?
Yes.
Okay, we need to discuss stuff. That sounds ominous. Yeah. Thankfully, this episode is pretty much done as it stands right now. So I'm gonna go stand over by Undula Bay because it's beautiful and the music is nice. And next time, hopefully this recording actually turned out. Next time with Pokemon, we will, I don't know, explore Undula Bay, or Undula Town, Undula Bay, up and down from here. I forget which way we can even go. I think we can explore the route to the south, but we might get blocked off before we can get to... Looks at Smudge writing on hand... Black City. Wow, what a great name for a town, you guys. Alright, see you later.